Hello students, in this video I'll be demonstrating another example of singular value decomposition for the matrix 2 3 0 2. Now both A transpose and A transpose A will be of order 2. So we can choose either of the two to get the problem. Now A is U sigma B transpose. Since we have a square matrix, U will be 2 cross 2, sigma will be 2 cross 2, and so will be the matrix V. Now U is orthogonal matrix of orthogonal modal matrix of A transpose. B is orthogonal modal matrix of A transpose A. Now A transpose will be 2 3 0 2 2 0 3 2, which will be 13 6 6 4. So A transpose minus lambda I, the determinant equal to 0 implies lambda squared minus 17 lambda plus 16 equal to 0. So lambda will be 1 and 16. So rearranging them in descending order, so sigma 1 will be root 16, that is 4, and sigma 2 will be 1. So sigma will be 4 1 0 0. Now A transpose, this implies U. So we have A transpose minus lambda I into X equal to 0 implies 2 cap. Which are the orthonormal vectors related to the eigen, corresponding to the eigenvalues 16 and 1. So lambda equal to 16, this implies A transpose minus 16 I will be 13 6 6 and 4. So this will be minus 3 6 6 minus 12. So A transpose minus 16 I will reduce to minus 1 minus 3 6 0 0. A transpose minus 16 I into X equal to 0 implies minus 3 X plus 6y equal to 0. Y equal to k implies x equal to 2k. So x1 is 2, 1. Similarly, lambda equal to 1. This implies A transpose minus I equal to 12, 6, 6, 3, which will reduce to 12, 6, 0, 0. A transpose minus I into x equal to 0 implies 12x plus 6y is 0. So y equal to k implies, or we can take y to be 2k. This implies x equal to minus k. So we can have x2 to be minus 1. Now x1 is 2, 1. This implies inner product of x1, x2 is 0. Therefore, inner product of x1 equal to 2 squared plus 1 squared, which is 5. Inner product of x2 is minus 1 squared plus 2 squared, which is 5. So u1 equal to x1 by norm x1, which is 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5, and u2 is x2 by norm x2, which is minus 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5. So u equal to 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5, minus 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5. Now A equal to U sigma V transpose. This implies U transpose A equal to sigma V transpose, or A transpose U equal to V sigma transpose. So VI equal to 1 by sigma I A transpose UI. For sigma I not equal to 0. Therefore, V1 will be 1 by sigma 1 A transpose UI, that is so this will be 1 by 4 into A transpose is 2032 into U1 is 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5. So this will be 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5. B2 is 1 by sigma 2, A transpose U2, that will be 1 by 1 into 2032 into minus 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5. So this will be minus 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5. So V will be 1 by root 5, 2 by root 5, minus 2 by root 5, 1 by root 5. And A equal to U sigma B transpose.